Hi dear students, in this video we will discuss about exercise 3.1 class 11th question number 3 onwards. See what is given in third question of this. A wheel makes 360 revolutions in 1 minute. So a wheel rotated 360 times in 1 minute, and you know 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds, and then we have to check through how many radians does it turn in 1 second? How many times it will rotate in 1 second, that we will find first. Then we will go for the angle. How much angle in radians it will cover in that number of revolutions. So see how to start it. First of all, start from here. How many revolutions it takes in 1 minute? It takes in 1 minute 360 revolutions. So we will write number of revolutions taken in 1 minute, to which we can say 60 seconds. 360 revolutions and number of revolutions or rotations taken in 1 second. I am concentrating on seconds because our requirement is in 1 second. So in 1 second, unitary method says we have to divide 360 by 60. It will be revolutions, so it will go on 6. So you have 6 revolutions in 1 second. Now we will change the wording of writing, that is angle in 1 revolution. One time when it rotates, it covers how much angle? It covers 360 degree. Or in radian, if we want, we can mark it as 2 pi radian. 180 means pi, 360 means 2 pi. Try to remember. So we will write here angle subtended by wheel in 1 revolution. It is 2 pi radian, and it is clear how many revolutions it takes in 1 minute. Angle subtended by wheel in 6 revolutions. It will be 6 times of this 2 pi radian, or in the end we can say it is a 12 pi radian, which is required answer of this question number 3. I think there is no difficulty to understand this thing. Firstly, we checked how many revolutions it takes in 1 second. Then you have to find angle for that number of revolutions, which is actually number of revolutions taken in 1 second. So this was third. Now see what is given in question number 4 after this. Students, our question number 4 is find the degree measure of the angle. You have to find answer in degrees. Degree measure of the angle subtended at the center of a circle of radius 100 centimeters. So there is a circle given whose radius is 100 centimeters. No doubt there will be center of the circle also. By an arc of length 22 centimeters. There is an arc whose length is 22 centimeters. Means L given equal to 22 centimeters. You have to find the angle subtended. Suppose angle is theta, which you have to find in degrees, at the center of circle of radius 100 centimeters. So radius of circle is 100 centimeters. But you need answer in degrees. But try to remember, this kind of relation in R, theta and L, means L equal to R, theta, you mark in radians, but you need answer in degrees. So keep in mind, this calculation of L, R, theta is in radians. Your need is answer should be in degree measure. So let's start by writing it. Solution is given. What is length of arc? Length of arc, it is L, 22 centimeters. Radius of circle, it is R, which is 100 centimeter. Let theta be the angle at the center of circle. because L is equal to R theta, we can say L, what is L? 22 centimeters equal to R 100 centimeters into theta. Theta is not given. Firstly, centimeters cancelled. And when you write theta, it will be 22 over 100 or 0.22 radian. Try to remember it is in radians. But we need answer in degrees. Here we will use conversion into degrees. You try to remember how you convert your angles of radian into degrees. Multiply it with 180 over pi and mention it is now in degree. Now only calculation work left. If I write 0.22, it will be 22 over 100 again into 180. Pi means 22 over 7, so it will be 22 in the denominator, 7 will go in the numerator. 0 cancelled. Further, 22 also cancelled with 22. And here 18 into 7, 126 over 10 or 12.6 degree. But we can't mark in this way 12.6 degrees. We have to convert this into minutes and seconds. So the thing which you have to remember, that is you have to write its cancellation. Don't write in this way. It will be, yes, it will go on 63 and 5 will left. So it is 63 over 5 degrees. And if you want to convert this into proper answer, see how you have to write here. Divide your 63 by 5. And it will go on 1 first, 5, 1 left, 13, 2, 10, 3. Now it is 12, 3 over 5 degree. Which we can mark, it is 12 degrees plus 3 over 5 degrees. And further we will convert this into minutes. 12 degree plus 3 over 5 into 60. Now it is in minutes. And if you want to solve it, you have 12 degree plus, cancellation is possible, it will give 12. 12 into 3, 36 minutes. Or we can say 12 degree, 36 minutes. This was our question number 4. I hope you are understanding these things in easy way. So this work you have already done in question number 1-2. But try to remember this new way of writing statement. This was 4th, now see what is given in question number 5 after this. Students, 5th question is also very simple. In a circle of diameter 40 cm. So it is given like this. Diameter of circle. Diameter of circle is 40 centimeters, and you can easily find the radius. So radius of circle, we can mark it as small r, 40 over 2 or 20 centimeter. The length of a chord is 20 centimeters. Let's draw one diagram. Suppose center of circle is O, chord is given of length 20 centimeter, and radius of circle also you marked as 20. This is radius. Here also it will be the same, 20 centimeter. You have to find the length of the minor arc of the chord. This is the minor arc, which we can say it is L. You have to find length of this minor arc. But you know LR and angle formed at the center, they are related with a formula L equal to R theta, but it is in radian. It is in radian only, but your calculation is not having any angle. But try to see, all these three sides are equal, and if all these are equal, we can say this. Suppose chord is AB, so this OAB triangle is equilateral. And if it is equilateral, try to remember what should be the value of this angle theta. Then let me write it once. Let AB be the chord of circle such that length of chord AB equal to given 20 centimeters. Also, let theta be the angle at center of circle, because in because in triangle, this triangle OAB, all sides OA, AB and OB, they all are equal to 20 centimeter. They all are equal, therefore this triangle OAB is equilateral. And if it is equilateral, as you know, therefore all angles of triangle OAB are of 60 degree. And if all angles are of 60, I am going to erase this. If all angles are of 60 degree, we can say this theta is also equal to 60 degree at the center. And degrees you have to convert into radian first, because this formula is applicable only for radians. So I am going to change it. 60 into pi over 180 radians. So you have to remember this conversion, students. Again and again we are using it, is pi over 3 radian. So we have angle in radian. Now only you have to use these given informations. What is radius of circle? I am writing radius of circle, which is r, 20 centimeter. Again I am writing this. And you have r, theta, and you need l. So l is not given. You write formula, because l equal to r theta, and see what answer it will give. So l equal to r. What is r? 20. And centimeters with it, into theta, which is pi over 3. So this is 20 pi over 3 centimeters. So this is our answer of question number 5. This way you can find length of the arc, but don't forget to change your angles into radian. Not only okay in radian, take care of these diagrams also. They are very beneficial. They are helpful to solve questions in easy way. Next, see what is given in question number 6. Question number 6 is in two circles. There are two circles. Let me draw two circles first. Okay. In two circles, they are given arcs of same length. There are two arcs and they are of same length. So let me write two arcs. Suppose this is first arc, it is L1. And in this also, suppose there is a center, okay, O. And in this you have O dash. There are two different circles. Another is having arc L2, but it is given they are of equal length. L1 and L2 are equal. So in two circles, arcs of same length subtend angles 60 degree and 75 degrees. So in first circle, suppose it forms angle 60 degree at the center, to which you can give name theta 1, 60 degrees. And here in other one, it forms angle 75 degree. You can mark it as theta 2. But they are in degrees. Then they are given, find the ratio of their radian. So let us write it, okay, what is given in the circles, arcs of same length. So given, let L1 and L2 be the two arcs of given two circles having radii. Their radii are R1 and R2 respectively, such that L1 and L2 they are given equal. So it is given, you can mark it as 1 for the time. Also theta 1 and theta 2 be the angles formed by arcs L1 and L2 respectively. So theta 1 is given equal to 60 degree, but this is in degree. Students, try to remember formula of LR theta is in radians, so we have to convert this into radians. So 60 into pi upon 180 radian. Conversion you should know. So it will be pi over 3 radian. Now we have to convert theta 2 also. So I am writing theta 2 here, 75 degree, which can be written as 75 into pi over 180 radian. radian. See, cancellation is possible or not? 25, no, it will go on 15. 15 into 5, 75. 15, 1, 15 into 2. 15 into 12, 180. So you have 5 pi over 12 radian. So they are the angles. Let's write these values. What about L1 and L2 now? We will write these values and we will use their answers in equation number 1, which you already marked here. So I am leaving this for the time here as it is. Let's write L1. L1, which will be R1 theta 1. L1 equal to R1 theta 1. Radius number 1, which is here, okay. What is radius number 1? That is not given because you have to find ratio of their radii. But you have L1. What is L1? It is given equal to L2. So I am writing L1 as it is. What about R1? R1 also we don't know. What about theta 1? Theta 1 you solved here. That is pi over 3. This is our equation number 1. You can mark it as radian here. Okay. And you can mark L2 now in the same way. R2 theta 2. Means L2 equal to R2 as it is. Theta 2 is here. 5 pi over 12 radian. But L1 and L2, they are equal. You know it is from equation number 1. We will mention here from 1. Now, L1 and L2, they are equal. Put their values in this. L1 is here. R1 into pi over 3 radian. And what about L2? It is with you here. R2 into 5 pi over 12 radian. Radian cancelled. Pi cancelled. And further, try to solve it for ratio of radii because they have given find ratio of their radii. So I am writing now R1 and going to shift R2 to the right, left side. It will go here in the denominator of left side, and this 3 will go in the numerator of right side. So 3 into 5 or 5 into 3 over 12, or we can say cancellation possible, you will get 5 over 4. So lastly, you can say R1 is to R2, ratio of these two is equal to 5 is to 4. So this was our question number 6. See what is given next in question number 7. Students, our last question number 7 is the easiest one in this exercise 3.1. See what is given. Find the angle in radian. So you have to find angle in radian through which a pendulum swings if its length is 75 cm. So a pendulum given, suppose this is a fixed point, okay. Length of the pendulum is given. It is what? 75 cm. Length of pendulum. Don't think that it is L. L is that arc through which it moves. Okay. Suppose this is its next position. This is given, length of pendulum means R given, 75 centimeters. So you have to find the angle. Suppose angle subtended is equal to theta, which is not given. So find the angle in radian through which the pendulum swings if its length is 75 centimeters and the tip describes an arc of length. This is the tip. It describes an arc of length. In each part you will see a new value. Here in first part I am going to write solution of part 1 first. So here it is given equal to 10 cm. Since this angle is given in radian, so you have to write formula of L, R and theta as L equal to R theta. Let's write here given. What is given? R 75 cm. And you have L equal to 10 cm. And you need one answer which is theta, and there will be a direct calculation. Mention because L equal to R theta, or L 10 cm equal to R 75 cm into theta. Theta is not given. Now centimeter cancelled and theta equal to 10 over 75, or 5 into 2 10, 5 into 15. So it is 2 over 15. Radian. So we have our answer of first part. Easiest one. Now we will go further for part number 2. So I will try to write answer of part 2. I hope you have done this okay work. You mark diagram in your notebooks or you are understanding these things. So I am going to erase this and we will solve part number 2 along with this part number 1. So in part 2 you have, see what is given. R will remain same, 75 centimeters. L will change, length of the arc, which is 15 centimeters. Theta again you need, but mention because L equal to R theta, same formula, 15 centimeter equal to R, what is R? 75 centimeters into theta, centimeter cancelled, so 15 over 75 equal to theta, or it will give 1 over 5, so theta equal to 1 over 5 radian. This was our part number 2. Now see what is given next in third part. I will do changes here only in third part. In third part you have to change only length of arc from 10 to 21. And here also calculation will change. I am changing here 10 to 21. Then here in the last step you have to write proper answer. So you have theta equal to 21 over 75. Or it will go on 3 into 7, 21. 525, so a 7 over 25 radian. This was our third part of question number 7. I hope you are understanding these in easy way. So don't forget to subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for latest notification. Stay connected, watch all the videos till end. Thanks for watching again. Bye bye.